Finally, we have Yusuf Salman, who's going to do a 6-minute presentation.
I'm Yusuf Salman. Today, I'll be doing the lead presentation for the ranking cycle experience. First, I'll tell you a little bit about the ranking cycle. It's a common cycle used in vapor power plants. It consists of four major components. First, you have a boiler in which heat is transferred from a burning of fossil fuel, nuclear fission, or geothermal source. Then steam, high pressure and temperature, leaves the boiler, goes into a turbine where work is produced. Where work is produced, this fluid expands isentropically and then goes into a condenser at a much lower pressure where it's cooled with an external working fluid. And once this fluid is cooled, it's brought into a pump. And work from the pump takes fluid from the condenser and provides the boilers feed water and completes the cycle. So the objective of the experiment, we want to be able to calculate the mass flow rate of the system, the work at the pump, the work input at the pump, the heat gain of the boiler, the heat out of the condenser, the work produced at the turbine and the turbine's cool spinning efficiency, and the cycle's first of all thermal efficiency. We're going to do this using recorded temperatures, pressures, flow rate, and steam tables. So go over some of the equations. This first equation, the first two equations come from doing the control volume of the pump and mass and energy balance. It gives you that the work input at the pump divided by the mass flow rate is equal to the change in enthalpy. I can be rewritten into these two separate equations with pressure. Doing similar control volume around the other components gives you the boiler heat equation, the condenser heat out, and the turbine workout. The turbine efficiency comes from comparing the actual adiabatic work that's produced in the turbine with the ideal isentropic work. And the first law of thermal efficiency compares the heat out of the condenser with the heat in at the boiler. Show you our apparatus. This will be some of the main components. These are some of the main components. First main component is the university boiler. This provides steam from LSU's power plant. We have a single stage Copus RL12L turbine, which we'll be using to produce work from the steam. And we have a CoiQuip 316 stainless steel plate counterflow heat exchanger, which will be used to cooling the working fluid. We have a steam separator, which is placed before the turbine. This improves the quality of the steam before it enters the turbine. This helps to stop water hammering and also increases the turbine's efficiency. We have steam traps placed throughout the system. Steam traps collect water condensate in them and a fluid within the steam trap slowly gets pushed up and condensate within the steam trap is released to the boiler feed water tank. So for the procedure, first we'll open all the white valves and leave all the black valves closed except for valve 4. We'll open up V2 and slowly open valve 1 until we get 100 psi at first pressure gauge. Then we'll slowly start to open V3 until we get the turbine at 1000 RPM for it to warm up. And then we'll open an eighth of a turn every 2 minutes until we get 3500 RPM. And we'll wait until it reaches 3600 RPM. And we'll wait 5 minutes for it to stay state. So, click data, we'll first take our data from the 6 pressure meters. We'll use the temperature cycle switch to take our 6 thermocouple readings. We'll use a multimeter to take the voltage across the generator and take the flow rate of the system from the flow meter. So I calculated the expected results with the assumptions given in the lab manual. First assumption was that we have saturated vapor leaving the boiler. That corresponds with this point here. And so, saturated vapor leaves the boiler, it expands isentropically, so no change in entropy. And we have atmospheric pressure at both sides of the condenser. We have saturated liquid leaving the condenser. This gave me the bold values on this table. From the steam table, I was able to find the rest of these values. And with this, I found the estimate for the thermal efficiency of the system. Using this equation, I replaced the heat out with the heat in. The heat out and heat in with the change in enthalpy. This gave me an estimated thermal efficiency of 13.6%. Very good questions.
So which one of the devices in the whole steam engine cycle is the least efficient in our experiment?
Is the least efficient in our experiment?
Yeah.
The least efficient device in our experiment. I'm not sure. What is the least
efficient? It's the turbine.
Turbine. Very good.